Martin Fishman here from the beautiful Cannes. We are interviewing amazing personality, and this gentleman is an artist itself, and his name is Raghunath Manet.
Raghunath Manet.
Raghunath, tell us why you are so famous around the world.
Well, I simply dance. I do Dance of Shiva. I'm a performer in music and dance. In fact, I performed in Shakespeare Globe.
Fantastic. I hear that you also perform at the Royal Festival Hall.
That's right. So I perform a lot in France and in Europe, everywhere, in fact. But I'm here in Cannes because I brought a first documentary movie, which I've done, about the Dance of Shiva.
The Dance of Shiva. And for the people that they don't know about what is the Shiva means, the Queen of Shiva, could you Could you tell me the meaning of it?
Well, Shiva is the oldest god of the world, is an Indian god. And what was interesting for me, I wanted to show to the world three questions. Who is Shiva? Why our god, Indian god, is the dancer, the king of dance, is Nataraja, he dancing? Why he dances? And what is the philosophy of Shiva, called Shivaism? It is very interesting because today everybody knows about Hinduism, but the oldest form is Shivaism. Don't forget that Shivaism gave birth to Buddhism. No. Buddhism was born in India, and somehow it has disappeared. It was inspired by the philosophy of Shiva. That's a great thing that people have forgotten it.
Yeah.
Because it's not a religion, it is a philosophy. Shiva says, don't be scared in the world. I'm here to protect you. No caste, no difference among the people.
So what do you think in India at the moment that a religion or mentality have been lost? Because I think that Buddhism, the only one place is in Nepal, that there is the most Buddhism in the world, not in India. What happened there?
Well, somehow we still pray a lot. We practice the Shivaism, at least in Tamil Nadu. I come from Pondichéry, the French territory. So the love for Shiva, it's still there. That's why when you go to the south of India, everybody invites you somewhere because they have to share things. They have to share food. They have to welcome the people. All this part of the Shivaism, where we get together, it's a kind of unity among the human beings. They have to find God between us.
That's amazing. And tell me again, how do you do that? Why is that? How do you know that that is the symbol and how that's expression of Shiva?
That's a specialization of the Indian arts. We call, I'm a practitioner of Bharathanatyam. Bharathanatyam is the oldest dance from the world. So we have symbols like Patakam, Tri Patakam, Ardha Patakam, Kartari Mugam, Mayuram, Ardha Chandram, Aral, Shukatundam, Mushti, Shikaram, Kapitam, Kadaka Mugam, Suchi, Chandrakala, Patmakosa, Sarpasirastata, the snakes, etc., etc. And Shiva, symbolism of Shiva is wearing in his hair the goddess Ganga. He's wearing the moon, which brings the lights to enlighten the people. The snakes runs around his body, who protects the people. And he dances, he said, he protect the whole universe. He embraced them. That's Shiva.
My God, it's so beautiful. It's amazing. All these symbolisms, I mean, it's so difficult. How many years you've been learning all of this?
I always say when I was inside my mom, I learned to dance. Well, I think we all have a body, and the dance is a medium to communicate. It's something beautiful. When you feel good, you dance. That means that dance is a part of the happiness. That's why we invented also the god of Shiva. He's a dancer. And the first sound is he brings out, it's called Om, Om Namah Shivaya, from which the world elaborates.
Fantastic. People do meditate with this Om all the time. So now I can actually get a little bit of it.
That is the first sound of the world. Om. And everywhere the sounds got together to become a music. and everything was created.
Tell me something. Now, when you're dancing, what the feelings come from? Now, if you were saying that you wake up this morning, I'm not a morning person. So I wake up in the morning, I'm like, oh God, I hate this. But when you're feeling down and you have to perform something happy, how can you fight the feeling that you have inside with the happy song? I don't know. How can you express something that you are not feeling, if you know what I'm saying?
I'm somebody who is very, how do you call, I love lights. I love the sun. When I see the sun, I'm happy. So as soon as I see the sun getting up, I'm very happy.
But I live in London.
Doesn't matter.
They don't have sun in there.
That's why it's very spiritual, in the sense that you have to bring out the sun from inner.
Within.
That's right. That's all the philosophy of Shiva. How you're going to become one with the God, one with the nature, one among the humanity and the divinities.
Thank you. Awesome.